and explain Lenz's law. Statement. See, with Faraday's law, we got magnitude. With Lenz's law, you will get direction. So the direction, Pathan? Pathan, when is your exam? Hello, Pathan, when is your exam?
Hello, hello, sir.
When is your exam of this chapter, EMI and AC?
Sir, actually, they have not given date.
Okay.
Till now.
Okay. Direction of induced current. Or induced EMF is such that it always opposes the cause producing it. That means suppose it is due to increase in flux, it will try to decrease. If it is due to decrease, it will try to increase. If it is due to falling, it will avoid falling. If it is due to coming right, it will try to push it on the left. This is the meaning. So direction of induced current or induced EMF is such that it always opposes the cause producing it, right? Then explanation we'll see. Now we'll see explanation. First, a magnet with its north pole facing the coil is brought towards the coil. If it is brought towards, coil will allow it to come or it won't allow by Lenz's law? By Lenz's law, it will allow or it will not allow?
Not allow.
It will not allow. North pole is repelled by which pole? North pole?
North.
North pole.
So that means this face of coil will send the get the current in such a way that it is behaving like north pole. North pole means current is in which direction? Anti-clockwise. So if the magnet with its north pole facing the coil is brought towards the coil, then current is induced in anti-clockwise direction and face of coil behaves as north pole of dipole, tries to repel the magnet, thus opposes cause producing it. Suppose we have north pole moving away, then it will try to attract by developing south pole. South pole means current will be in clockwise direction. So when the north pole of a magnet is moved away from the face of coil, then current is induced in clockwise direction and coil behaves as south pole of dipole, thus tries to attract the magnet, opposes the cause producing it. Draw this two diagram, then I will give you the explanation in writing.
Done, sir.
Okay. Then a magnet with its north pole facing the coil is brought towards the coil. When a magnet with its north pole facing the coil is brought towards the coil, then current is induced in anti-clockwise direction and face of coil behaves as north pole of dipole and tries to repel the magnet, thus opposes the cause producing it. Next line. Then magnet with its north pole facing the coil is moved away from coil, then current is induced in clockwise direction and face of coil behaves as south pole of dipole and tries to attract the okay, please copy this much. So whenever current is in anti-clockwise, that face behaves like north pole of dipole. Completed now.
Done, sir.
Okay.
tries to attract the magnet. Tries to attract the magnet, thus opposes the cause producing it. This explains Lenz's law. Okay, written this much. Have you written this?
Yes, sir.
Deduce theoretically Faraday's and Lenz's law, or so that E equals to minus d phi by d. So far we were doing Faraday's perform experiment. Now we have to check by theory whether it is true or not. To get maximum flux, what should be the field? Perpendicular or inclined?
Perpendicular,
correct. So consider a rectangular coil P, Q, R, S. Circular liya to bhi chalega, but we are taking rectangular coil so that its area is always length into breadth. And if it is circular coil, if you take, then if this much part is in the field, then this is area of one segment, area of another, it will be difficult. But rectangle area length into breadth is easy to find. So we are taking rectangular coil. Any closed coil will do. Consider a rectangular coil to be placed partially in a uniform magnetic field of induction B bar perpendicular to the plane of page but inverse. Means it is perpendicular but directed inside the plane. Let L be the length of vertical side and X be the length of horizontal side of the coil in the field. When coil is pulled towards right with velocity V, then electron inside this conductor will move with velocity V. And if electron moves perpendicular to the field, they will experience force QVB. This you know from moving charge?
Yes.
And if there is force, that means charge is in motion, then current I is induced according to Fleming's left hand rule. Can you tell me direction of force in PQ? Direction of current in PQ? By Fleming's right hand rule. Field is where? Inward. To get induced current, we require field, we require right hand thumb rule, force left hand rule. Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Index finger is direction of field. Index finger represents direction of field.
Yes.
So show that index finger towards wall where you are sitting and thumb on the right side with its motion. Then can you see middle finger is pointing upward? Index finger towards yes. wall, thumb on the right, middle finger upar ja raha hai kya?
Yes.
So current I will be induced in clockwise direction according to Fleming's right hand rule. If current carrying conductor is placed in field, will there be force? If current carrying conductor is placed in field, will there be force? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
And that yes, force sir. Ka direction is found by Fleming's left hand rule?
Yes.
Yes.
Check kar the direction. For PQ, we'll check the direction. Left hand, yeah? Field is inward. Current upar. किधर आया था हम मुझे तो लेफ्ट में आ रहा है आपको
लेफ्ट
लेफ्ट में सो दिस विल बी द फोर्स एक्सपीरियंस इन लेफ्ट फॉर पीएस वेयर यू आर फाइंडिंग द डायरेक्शन फॉर पीएस फील्ड इनवर्ड करंट राइट किधर गया था हम मुझे तो ऊपर दिख रहा है आपको फील्ड इनवर्ड करंट राइट थम ऊपर ना
यस
एंड फॉर एस आर नो फोर्स बिकॉज देर इज नो फील्ड इन क्यू आर करंट इज टू द लेफ्ट तो मुझे थम नीचे आया आपको ये भी यही मिला बाय फ्लेमिंग्स लेफ्ट हैंड रूल इंडेक्स फिंगर इन साइड
यस सर
हाँ और कॉमन सेंस है अगर ये राइट के लिए ऊपर आया तो लेफ्ट के लिए नीचे ही आएगा ना Just draw this diagram, then I'm explaining everything once again. If diagram is done, please let me know.
Done, sir.
Okay. Consider a rectangular coil PQRS. To be placed in a uniform magnetic To be placed partially, not completely, partially in a uniform magnetic field of induction B bar, which is perpendicular to plane of page but inwards let l comma x be length and ab diagram mein b kar do let l comma b be length and breadth of coil in the field when coil is moved towards right with velocity v then charges Q, that is free electrons in conductor, experiences force F equals to QVB. Copy till this. So first the experience force, then induced current, then the magnetic force. This will be our sequence. Copy till this.
Answer.
So it experiences force F equal to QVB. And if there is force, there is motion. Due to motion of charge, we get current. Due to this force, current I is induced in clock wise direction according to Fleming's right hand rule. Due to this induced current, vertical side PQ experiences force F1 equal to ILB towards left. The horizontal sides QR and PS PQRS, so horizontal QR and PS experiences equal and opposite forces F2, F3. Hence, they cancel each other. Thus, the only unbalanced force is F1 acting towards left. Yes. Copy this much. So we have proved that there is only one force which is opposing the motion acting towards left. Copy.
approach 12,000 kilograms. F1 towards left. Now let the coil be moved towards right with towards right by distance dx. Therefore, work done against force, comma dw is minus f1 dx. So minus I lb into dx, but l dx equals to dA equal to change in area. Therefore, dW is minus I B dA, but B is d phi upon dA. Therefore, B dA equals to d phi equals to change in magnetic flux. Therefore, dW is minus I d phi. So dW upon dt is minus I d phi by dt. What is rate of doing work called as? What is rate of doing work called as? Power, rate of doing
power.
Work power. Okay. Just come till this, then we do further. We are doing. Come till this.
Done, sir.
But rate of doing work is called as mechanical power P equals to d by dw upon dt. So P is
minus I d phi by dt. This mechanical power is utilized to generate induced EMF E, which maintains induced current I. Therefore, electrical power, this is I'm calling P1, this I'm calling P2, equals to E into I. But mechanical power is electrical power. So therefore, from 1 and 2, we get EI is minus I d phi by dt. I will get cancelled. So therefore, E is equals to minus d phi by dt. This proves Lenz's law theoretically. By theory, we got this answer. Have you followed the concept till end?
Yes.
Hello? Sir. Yes. Please copy till end. Then take 2 minutes, read everything. Any doubt occurs, ask me. Completed till end?
Done. Okay.
Now just take 2 minutes, read everything. Have you followed till end? Just check.
magnetic field 8 by 2 on magnet south energy 940. आगे आते थोड़ा कुछ निकालेंगे आप.
Read everything?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So we have proved that EMF induced is minus d phi by dt. Now, very, 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 very important derivation. Derive expression for EMF induced. See, this what we did in coil, it was pulled, means translatory motion. Now we are telling derive expression for EMF induced in rotating coil, not translating, but rotating coil. Derive expression for EMF induced in rotating coil. When I see the coil from side, I cannot see this circle. I will see only this thickness, huh? This part.
Yes.
So I'm drawing the coil. That means I'm seeing from this side, not from this side. So when you see from this side, only thickness you will be able to see like this. So its area can be circular, it can be square, it can be rectangle, we don't. Depending upon that shape, area ka formula will keep on changing. Now see first paragraph. Consider a coil PQ having n number of turns, area of cross section A, to be placed with its plane perpendicular to the uniform magnetic field of induction B bar. Let the coil be rotated with uniform angular velocity omega. Coil be rotated with uniform angular velocity omega. Let P1 Q1 be the position of coil at any instant t. Therefore, angular displacement theta equals to omega t. See, P1, Q1 is position of coil at any instant t. So, what will be angular displacement theta? Will it be omega into t? Not followed?
Yes, sir.
Omega into t. At this position, normal to the plane of coil will make angle theta with the direction of field. Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
So field can be resolved into two components, B cos theta along normal and B sin theta parallel to the plane of coil. Okay.
Yes.
What will be the flux passing through the coil at any instant? Can I say N A B cos theta, which is N A B cos omega t? Therefore, by Faraday's and Lenz's law, induced EMF, comma E is minus of rate of change of magnetic flux associated with the coil. I hope you followed this concept till this. Is this clear concepts?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
just
sir.
Draw the diagram, then writing part, then copy this. Only diagram you draw. Very, very important. Those who are having this chapter in the college exam, if it is theory paper, definitely they will ask this.
Done, sir.
Okay. 1 minute. Don't copy anything. Only diagram. Diagram part. Can I clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right. Consider a coil PQ. Consider a coil PQ having n turns, comma, area of cross section A to be placed with its plane perpendicular to the direction of field of induction B bar. Let coil be rotated with uniform angular velocity omega. Rotated with angular velocity omega. Let P1, Q1 be the position of coil at P second. Let's copy this much. Let P1, Q1 be the position of coil at P second. Is completed.
So that blue part also?
No. Only red. Only red part. Huh? Don't copy that blue wala. Completed?
Yeah.
Okay. So we got P1, Q1 be the position of coil at P second. Thus, angular displacement theta equals to omega t at any instant t, the normal to the plane of coil makes angle theta with field B bar. Hence, B bar can be resolved into two rectangular components, A B cos theta perpendicular to plane of coil, B sin theta parallel to plane of coil. Again, copy only till this. Only copy till B sine theta parallel to plane of coil.
Done, sir.
Completed, no? Therefore, flux passing through coil at any instant t, comma phi equals to, now copy till end. Tomorrow, is it possible to attend extra class? 10 to 11?
Okay, no problem.
Hello, sir. Say?
Math class, extra lecture.
At what time?
10.
See, I'm just fixing the lecture so that you can tell your respective teachers. Otherwise, you don't say the lecture. Whenever teacher wants, they keep the lecture. Last Thursday, so you are free?
Yes, sir.
Till what time you have got class?
11.
Then 9 to 10 at 10.
So done.
Last time, this is expression for EMF induced in rotating coil. That much, sir?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
As above, expression contains sign function. Hence, it is alternating in nature and also called as alternating or AC EMF. Right. It is denoted by this symbol. Graph of alternating EMF versus time. Thank you.
हेलो
हो गया दोनों पेपर, दोनों पेपर हो गया क्या? एक कभी हुआ सुबह, सेकंड पेपर अभी हुआ ना, तो 11 का भेजता हूँ उसको, देखो अभी 11 का प्लानर भेजता हूँ वो देख के करना। उसमें एमसीक्यू 25 मार्क का आएगा और 10 मार्क 15 मार्क का थियरी देने वाले थे, तो 25 क्वेश्चन ही आएगा भेजता हूँ, एक मिनट हुआ। ओके सो टुडे वी स्टॉप हियर, नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल